and chips, and I just realized I don't have my. There we go. Now I am official. Anyway, how is it that sometimes when you try to share your faith with your loved ones, it just seems like it's falling on deaf ears? And what do you do about that? Jesus speaks about this to his disciples and in our reading today for the gospel. And listen to what Jesus tells them. He says, Jesus said to his apostles, "Do not think that I have come to bring peace upon the earth. I have come to bring peace, not peace, but the sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law, and one's enemies will be those of his household." You ever felt that way? Maybe you're a family, when you were growing up, if you were a kid, your family didn't have a really close walk with God. And as a priest, I see families at different levels in their stages in their existence. And what happens sometimes, though, is one of the members has a churn, a change. Something happens in her or his life that reorients them towards God and faith. And sometimes what happens, and this happened in my family many decades ago, is people don't know how to respond to that, your loved ones, because all of a sudden you have changed. And then what happens is that when we are like that, we almost feel like we are, in our families, we're outcast or not understood. I remember talking to a priest friend of mine, sharing this experience with him, and he said, "Well, it happened to me too, but eventually they come around." Listen to what Jesus tells them. He says that enemies will be those of your own household. They just won't understand. But notice what I read next to you in this chapter. Listen to what happens. Jesus sends the disciples out to go to all these places to preach the gospel. They don't go to their own homes, their own hometowns. Listen to what it says instead. When Jesus finished giving these commands to his 12 disciples, he went away from that place to teach and to preach in their towns. You may be the least likely person to share matters of faith with your own family. It may not be your calling, but Jesus can go. Or Jesus can go in somebody else, but it's not always up to you. It's the same thing with Paul. Yeah, Paul was this brilliant theologian, thinker, Jewish person. He was a Pharisee of Pharisees and all these other things. And yet God sent him to preach to the Gentiles, to be apostle to the Gentiles. Somebody else had to be the apostles to the Jewish people about the gospel of Jesus Christ. So that's where you are a lot of times. Don't doubt, don't worry, don't think it's all for loss if you can't do it. Sometimes God has somebody else in line for that particular job for your loved ones. Let's have a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we do remember all those ones we love and care for who struggle with the gospel. Help us to love them, accept them as they are, and to be honest with who we are, but at the same time, always pray that Christ will go and make himself known in their lives in some special way. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you, and I hope you have a wonderful day.